All right, it's time for episode 9 of Moriarty the Patriot. Let's just get started in 3, 2, 1, go. So in the last episode, it was more or less Sherlock. I was getting some development on him. And with there being 3 more episodes, and more than likely a second season, we're gonna get one of those big cliffhanger moments, so. Oh yeah, and Sherlock got convicted of a crime. Only because his name was written in blood. So it's really hard to expect anything coming up. It's opening. Set a thief to catch another thief. Set a thief to catch another thief. Imagine like a whole like crowd with the glow stick gimmicks and just banging it to catch another thief. Sono time machine. And I feel like this one gonna be one of those series that it's gonna be good dubbed. Usually dubs don't really go so well, but I feel like this one is gonna be pretty good. Given that they select the right people. Okay, here we go. A study in S, Act 2. So essentially, Sherlock is in captivity. So he's gonna let Sherlock run free. Hiding under the bridge, Watson. Again, dead air, because there really isn't anything to say. So, I've got to reiterate it every episode. Golden ring. Just imagine if Moriarty and Sherlock teamed up instead of fighting each other. Damn. So the dying guy from the last episode wants this ring. I like how the newspaper's kind of obvious. Because, like, any other person would see it as just an advertisement. So, hoodlums. Wait, why does the guy have the girl's ring? Not Watson, but the guy who got killed. Oh, that's the killer's wife's ring. There you go. Nice CG door. Ooh. Wow. Number three, yeah. That's Fred, isn't it? There comes the CG carriage. He's being trailed by Sherlock. Wow, that looks fucking weird. He has his coat over his head. He's walking with his hands in his pocket. It's not even like a raincoat, it's a like suit coat. Kind of cut him off. Or just get dead-ended. Damn. Went all over the place. Oh, you got clapped. Yeah, they spelled it wrong. Spelled with a Z, not an S. Was Sherlock like this much of a dick in the books. Oh. I mean, I guess this works in tune with the kill the bad nobles thing. Damn. Hope. What? How? He didn't even have like a description of him. All he had was a name. Oh, okay. So he had health. It wasn't just a big, like, deduction thing. I was about to say, no way did he just solve this all by himself. Oh. Three shots. I'll tell you who told me to do this. In exchange for my freedom. He's got an illness already, so like it doesn't matter. He's got a gun. He wants Sherlock to be the one that kills him. Fred's there. Moriarty, whoever. Yeah, Fred. Wow. Okay, so I was half correct. He's gonna tell him Moriarty is the benefactor in exchange for him killing him. Yeah, that would just add on to his record, right? Watson pulled the gun on Sherlock. Yep, he did it. Yep. He likes the mystery. And if someone tells him the answer right away, then that's not fun. There you go. Wow. Now, wouldn't they have put Lestrade in hot water because he let Holmes out? I mean, he didn't let him out, but lost control of the horse. He ain't joining your team. Damn, this like build up of like you can feel the tension coming. Okay. Well then, this episode is a continuation of last episode. Oh god. We found out who the killer was. It was some dude named Hope. And no, yabba dabba, all that stuff happens. And then what else happened? Sherlock solved the case. And then he declined to kill Hope because he wants to solve the mystery himself. It sucks if you get the answer given to you. So that's a testament to Sherlock's character. Yeah, so that's about it. Like, I don't know. Nothing really big happened. Now that there's like three more episodes. And according to my website, a second season. I think this is one of those like slowdowns until episode like 11. No. What? They'll hell up. They'll have it once and he got shot. Or a spilled ketchup on himself. Oh, damn. Well, yeah, that was episode 9 of Moriarty the Patriot. Or Yukoku no Moriarty. Yeah. Like, comment, subscribe, on to next. Yeah.